right here?
Like the city. Yeah.
Okay.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. My name is Betsy Holland, and I represent District 54 in the Georgia House of Representatives. And I'm joined here by some colleagues of mine and some fellow concerned Fulton County residents to remind our friends, our family, and our neighbors that Herschel Walker is not possessed of the character or the confidence to represent Georgia in the U.S. Senate. I've been a public servant for some time, and while this may seem controversial, there's one thing I've learned. It helps to live to walk the grocery store aisles for you, not to a constituent but a problem, to answer questions to your neighbors at a PTA meeting, to be able to hear people's problems in the fellowship hall at church. Last week, we all learned that Herschel Walker has been receiving a tax break on his $3 billion Texas vote, intended only for primary residents, despite running for the Senate here in Georgia. Walker took that tax break in 2021 and 2022 after announcing this latest scandal shows that Walker broke that rule, potentially violating the Georgia election code by voting in our state and running for office here. I'm standing here today because voters deserve to know the truth. Walker refuses to take responsibility and has spent the past week and 6 weeks before avoiding questions from the press and from Georgians. The Georgia Bureau of Investigations and the Georgia Attorney General's Office must immediately investigate whether Herschel Walker has tried to game the system, and he got caught, and now he must be held accountable. Every day, Walker's pattern of dishonesty and disturbing conduct grows longer, and it's all the more proof that he has no business representing Georgia in the Senate. From falsehoods about his academic achievements, business successes, to flat-out lies about working in law enforcement and helping veterans, Walker has never been honest with voters. He has proven time and time again that we can't trust him, and this is yet another reminder that Walker lacks both the confidence and the character to be our U.S. Senator. The choice is clear, Georgia. We've got to re-elect Reverend Warnock, who has a record of actually bringing down costs, addressing supply chain issues, and creating good-paying jobs to sustain Georgia families. We have to do it one more time, Georgia. Please get out there and vote early. Early voting is open throughout the state and runs Friday, December 2nd, and if you miss those days, you can always do it on Tuesday, December 6th, at Virginia Precinct. I'm confident that next week, we're going to send Reverend Warnock back to the Senate, and send Herschel Walker back to his home in Texas. Thank you. Now I'd like to hand it over to my colleague, Representative Jimmy Wow.
Thank you, Representative Howell, for that. We appreciate that. Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us today. The latest scandals, Herschel Walker's long and kind of lies, scams, and disturbing conduct. I'm Representative Louis McClain, a proud member of the people of Georgia's House District 100, and I'm also former president of the Illinois Georgia FLCIO. As a public servant and a leader in the labor community, I know that there's nothing more important than being honest with fellow Georgians playing by the rules. That much I do know. That's why I'm so disappointed by the revelation that Herschel Walker is deceiving voters by taking tax breaks in Texas while running to represent Georgians. The Atlanta Journal-Constitution reported yesterday that Walker is facing calls for an investigation of whether he violated the law by receiving a tax break on his Dallas home, meant for primary residence, or even as he runs for federal office in Georgia. That's right. According to Herschel Walker, Texas, the primary residence is in Texas, even as he is running for office here in Georgia. Georgians need to elect someone that lives in Georgia. In other words, Herschel Walker has not been honest with Georgians about where his home is. He tried to game the system, and he's got it. The Georgia Bureau of Investigation should pursue this investigation to see if Walker broke the law. I encourage the GBI to look into that. Frankly, this is one more drop in the bucket of Herschel Walker's extremely damning pattern of lies, scam, and disturbing conduct that proves Walker is not ready to represent Georgians. How it things in community service. Where Walker moved out to Texas. Well, where I'm at, I'm also a college graduate, where Walker accuses to be a college graduate. I am a college graduate. I've been in public service for more than two decades, and I know a thing or two about what good leadership looks like. And it starts with honesty. Now, we've seen reports, after reports, showing that Herschel Walker lies about aspects of his life, you know, that's easily checked. I mean, no one should lie about something that, be hypocritical about something that can be easily checked. This is the same man who claimed that he run a business that didn't even exist, claimed to work for law enforcement, when we all know he never did, claimed to carry a gun, and we never saw it. This is the same man who claimed that he was helping veterans with their mental health while making a fortune, the fraud and the servicemen of a fellow gunman. Is that who we want representing Georgia?
No.
Is that who we want to represent Georgia?
No.
To represent our families, the answer is no.
No.
Competence matters, character matters, integrity matters. The choice is clear, Georgia. We've got to re-elect Rimmel Warnock, who has a record of bringing down costs, addressing supply chain issues, and creating good-paying jobs and situating the sustained Georgia families. In other words, actually working for Georgians instead of lying to them. Please get out there and vote early. Early voting runs through Friday, December 2nd. And if you miss that date, please go on Tuesday, December 6th. The stakes are just too high for our families. We need Rebel Warner, and we can't afford Herschel Walker. And I'd like to turn it over to my friend, the Senator of the Order for the Senator, Dan Arnold.
Thank you so much. Thank you, since Walker clearly cannot or won't
Beyond Walter's lies, he has a long history of violence, disturbing conduct, and he's never taken responsibility. He's denied, he's jibed, he's shoved, he's told everything but the truth, and especially when it comes to the treatment of women. And you know what? We care about that. That tells you a lot about a person's care. And just a couple of weeks ago, another of Walter's ex-girlfriends said that she had felt threatened by Walter. As a woman, as a parent, and as a concerned Georgian, that's not the leadership I want for our state. We deserve so, so much better than that. And fortunately, we have a true choice when we go to the polls.
Yes, yes.
Because while Walker makes a mockery of Georgians by lying to them over and over again, Reverend Raphael Warnock continues to fight for Georgians. He's been working in the U.S. Senate as our senator to lower costs, to protect jobs, to secure funding for our schools, and to stand up for hardworking Georgia families. He and I voted the same precinct. I know where Senator Warnock lives. I know where he lives. He lives in my neighborhood, and he votes the same precinct I do. There's no question about where he lives. It's clear, and it's no question about who he wants to serve. So the choice is very clear, Georgia. I joined Reverend Warnock on Sunday and voted early. I cast my ballot in the runoff for Reverend Warnock and against Herschel Walker. That's the choice we all have. That's the responsibility all of us take between now and the 6th of December. Early voting is open all week to December 2nd on Friday, and Election Day is Tuesday, December the 6th. So let's get this done. One more time. Thank you so much, and I'm so happy to bring to the podium a member of the House who is now a senator-elect right here in Georgia, who lives in Georgia, who works in Georgia, who pays taxes in Georgia.
You know
where you live. You know where you live. So thanks very much, and please welcome to the podium Senator-elect Josh McMahon.
It's an honor to be here with colleagues today, both the State House and the State Senate, speaking to Georgians, reminding Georgians to get out and vote, reminding Georgians of what the stakes are for this election. We learned yesterday, of course, that a complaint was filed in the Georgia Bureau of Investigation in the Attorney General's office, calling on authorities to investigate Herschel Walker for violating election law when he announced his candidacy and voted in Georgia, despite taking a homestead exemption in Texas. The law is clear. Lawyer, and I don't know Texas law like the back of my hand, but I think they've got pretty much the same rule as Georgia, which is you got to live in the state if you want to vote there.
Yeah.
And you got to live in the state if you want to run for office there. I think most Georgians, most Texans probably too, understand that. It's not that hard. We're a week away from the election, and voters are already heading to the polls. Now you might ask, why do we have such a compressed period of time to talk about these issues? Well, that's because Georgia Republicans shorten the amount of time that you get to vote in runoffs, which means that we have to cram all this in at the last minute. The point is that Georgia Republicans and Herschel Walker take Georgians for fools. They assume that Georgians are not going to do the work and Google and learn for themselves all the things that Herschel Walker has lied about. They assume that Georgians simply won't have enough time to vote, won't have enough time to learn the truth about Herschel Walker. And I think Representative McClain said it best when he said, these things aren't that hard to disprove, y'all. It doesn't take much work to figure out how much he's lying. But they still want to take Georgians for fools and assume that we're not going to figure out the truth. You heard Representative Hollis, Senator Warnock, describe his primary residence is in Texas. He's taking money from the government, tax breaks.
Shame.
Shameful. Based on his assertion that his primary residence is in Texas, meanwhile, registering to vote and voting in the state of Georgia. Folks, we have to hold Herschel Walker accountable. 11 lives tried to do that, tried to get information on his driver's license. Texas authorities say they need to match up Herschel Walker's driver's license, his name, to the properties of record to make sure that he's validly taking that exemption, and that investigation is underway in Texas. But when Georgia reporters try to get information from Herschel Walker about whether his name does in fact match, he won't disclose. He's hiding the ball.
All right.
What has he got to hide? If he really is a Georgia resident, we know because of public record that he's not. We know we reviewed the lies today that he has told, that he owned a business that had 800 employees, but it actually had 8. We know that Herschel Walker has bragged about starting a charity to help veterans, when in reality it was a for-profit scheme that preyed on vets and our service members. Bottom line is, people in Georgia know this is not who we need representing us in the U.S. Senate. And if you've heard Reverend Warnock speak, he knows this is bigger than party. This is not about Democrat, Republican.
Teach.
It's about who's right for Georgia and who's wrong for Georgia. Herschel Walker is wrong for Georgia. Reverend Warnock, however, has a demonstrated record of capping costs, insulin, trying to reduce costs for working families, putting Georgia, the people of Georgia, above politics, working with senators across the aisle to deliver real results for Georgians already in the term that he's already served. This is why people from both parties, people who I know personally, know that we have to re-elect Senator Reverend Warnock to the United States Senate. And we know that some of y'all watching probably already voted or planning to vote. We're asking you to ask other people in your life to vote. Get the word out. Get it out. It's too important to wait. There's no time to wait. Now is the time to vote. The stakes are too high, and we appreciate your time today. I'm happy to pass it over to Dan from the party, but we're also happy to take any questions that you might have. Thank you very much.
Any questions?
Can we cover the specific state law that you want the GBI to investigate?
So, it turns out my first race for the State House in 2018, Georgia Republicans spent a good bit of money trying to make the argument of the state election code that I was not eligible to run. Now, they were wrong. Judges all disagree with them. But I got to vote with Norman Russell's. And the state election law regarding residency, and specifically domicile, when it comes to eligibility to vote, eligibility to hold office, you have to swear under penalty of perjury that you are eligible to vote in the state of Georgia and run for office in the state of Georgia when you do those two things. Everybody who votes makes that affirmation, that attestation. Herschel Walker has voted in Georgia, and he has sworn that he is a primary resident of Georgia. His domicile is here, so he's legally eligible to do that. The problem is that's completely logically inconsistent with him affirming to the state of Texas, for purposes of his tax break, that he's a primary resident there. Both of those things can't be true. So if in fact he is a primary resident of Texas, we require an investigation. The seat is too important not to determine whether he lied under oath when he told Georgia authorities that he was eligible both to vote and run for office.
Will Democrats make a specific request to the GBI beyond the request that was made by a private citizen?
You know, that complaint process, to my understanding, is sufficient to start the wheels turning. And at this point, I think the cat's out of the bag. Georgians are aware of this issue. And if there will be an abdication of authority on behalf of our state authorities not to investigate this to its full conclusion, I have confidence in our nonpartisan GBI authorities. They've done a lot of great work when asked to look at Cobb County votes to verify there was no voter fraud there in the last election. The GBI is more than well equipped to look into this, and I have full confidence that no matter who the candidate was, the party affiliation of that candidate, they would serve the people of Georgia by fully investigating.
If the GBI should find that his primary residence is in Texas, should he be disqualified? If he's elected, should he be allowed to serve? What should happen?
Now, like I said, I'm a lawyer, and I'm not a full expert on exactly how the process would proceed at this point. So undoubtedly, there would be some litigation, maybe both civil and criminal. But the point here today, the reason we're civil today, is just to say that this is about trust. We've got an election too soon, and voters need to know that there is a serious proceeding underway to investigate these claims of voter fraud by one of our U.S. Senate candidates, Herschel Walker. So, regardless of how that investigation concludes, the people of Georgia deserve to know that that investigation is and should be underway, and that there will be answers within time. Thanks, Mary.
Thank you.